So I got the CRX in the garage. Got a pretty decent head start on it. Pulled the engine. And right now I'm working on getting all the seam sealer and every like plug out, make sure it's gonna be ready for me to sand down completely to redo this paint job, which I'm pretty sure somebody did a primer and they just never finished or whatever. They also painted over the blue with the red. It was such a good blue color with this crappy red paint job. But I already got a decent amount started on this side with the seam sealer and all the holes and stuff. I did find a plug I forgot to take out. Got to deal with like sanding down this stuff that they did. I don't even know what they were doing. But I'm going to keep working on this side, get her done, and then I'll start going on the other side. And I got a seat for it also to put in. And I'm putting in a D15 D7. But I got to still take off this trans and made it up with the SI trans over there so I can keep the cable and not have to deal with the hydro stuff. But I got it with only a dash, which is back there. And everything's pretty chill. There's nothing like crazy I have to do other than this, which most likely I'm just gonna cut this out and then cut a piece off of this off my EF frame that has this part and then have it welded in. I might try to do it myself so I can learn how and trust myself. But I already pulled out the whole entire engine harness. The steering column's out. It wasn't even bolted on, so that was easy to take out. I still want to take out the heater core and all this stuff to get the whole firewall accessible, clean it all up, do my wire tuck with the least amount of wires as I need, and start putting only the dash back together because that's all I got. And I think I'm going to just take the whole headliner off, even those back pieces, and just have it be gutted. And eventually I'd want to get like better bucket seats and 5-point harness and not run the door cards, but I'll have to for now because that's the only way to run the seat belts. And I also got a lot of mold to clean off these seat belts. I might just run the EF ones off the parts car that I have that are not as moldy. But for now, just got to get the bay painted. And it's not going to be like a final paint job. It's just going to be kind of to paint it, put that engine in, finish my tuck on the harness, know exactly what I'm doing, take it out and plug every whole thing that I'm not using and do a final paint job. But I will do like all the prep work on resealing the seams with seam sealer, just not as bulky. Like this side isn't the worst because there's not as much as the other side, but this side, this was just this huge glob and it was just horrible looking. So for now I'm gonna work on that. But engine's next. this section looks a lot better now. And I can tell why there's so much seam seal in there. It's a bunch of seams coming together. But that should be fine to smooth out. This is going to be a spot that really doesn't see much, but I don't think anything's going to go there, so it's going to have to look clean. But man, this whole side's pretty much done. Other than finishing up that spot a little bit, getting this plug out, and then dealing with this. But this is going to be more like actually with a grinder, I think, because sanding that down would take forever. I don't know what they were doing, but they did that in a bunch of spots. And then just left it, like, it looks like putty, like some steel stick, JB Weld stuff. So that's going to suck. It's even right here. I also have to bend this up, too. So there's still a lot more to do, but side's almost done. Gotta cut these off or drill out the spot right there and then pry them off. I don't know what I'm gonna do yet, but once this is done, I'm just gonna finish this up off camera. And then once that's done, then I start going on this side. And there is some stuff like this that I can remove, but yeah, this side's gonna suck after doing that. It's probably gonna take me like a week. Dude, I got lucky. When I started hitting it with the wire wheel, it chips off. And then, like, lets you start to smooth it down to actually what they tried to do. And it definitely smells like steel stick, I can tell, because it smells like fucking cat piss when you start grinding into it. Exactly like what it smells like when you're curing it. So hopefully that'll actually work, but I was just hitting it. And it started chipping, so I started hitting it more and just cleaned it right up. So that's good to know. It's just moving around now. Comes apart so easy with this. Now there's a hole. Now there's another hole. So I got a few more spots I need to hit to get all that stuff out. And then this side is pretty much ready to do the final sand. Day two, we got the heater core out of the way. And I also got those brake lines out of the way. Those are inside the car now. Last thing would be this fuel line, but I don't know for sure what I'm going to do with that. So I'm going to leave it. Worst comes to worst, I can tape it off, paint around it, which I'll probably end up having to do, or I'll do a different route. But I already got these corners done. Got every single spot that had that putty like the other side done. The last thing is this section, which I wanted to leave so I could get some shots of actually get rid of a just regular seam sealer, not like the process of after. So I have to get all of this this corner in here, and then up around. But this section's all done, all the way up into here. I got this corner as best I could. Looks a lot better than it was. And yeah, I'll get to that. Alright, so my light died, so I'm trying to use a flashlight to kind of get a better shot of it. But this whole section is done now. That stuff is already done down to here. I did all this, all the way up to there. And now that should be pretty much all the seam sealer done. And the last thing to do would just be kind of like go over everything and sand it. Which I'm going to do all that off camera, but this is getting pretty much close to ready for paint. Now there are some stuff that I could take off, like I said before, was stuff like this. But I'm literally going to leave everything, because just in case I want to utilize this for something, because you can make those brackets to slip into there. You can have them like 3D printed and stuff, so something could be held there if I needed to in the future. That's for the fuel filter. I'm going to definitely keep that. I like the stock look. Or that's for the fuel filter. Either way, I'll figure everything out once I paint it and put the engine in. But yeah, it's looking a lot better. That'll be the end of this video though. Pretty much just getting prepped. I'm going to sand everything else off camera. Not like down to bare metal, more like something like this. I'm going to try to finish most of it tonight, or all of it, but ideally I'll have to go to AutoZone and get some sandpaper and do the rest. But the CRX will be coming closer to being done soon. So that's it for this one. Next one I'll probably do some stuff with the engine, start putting stuff together. But I can't wait to start actually painting this soon. Still need to do the seam sealer, so next of this stuff will probably be like seam sealing, everything, primer, and then paint. Soon, it'll be ready to drive.